welcome to the Hodlnots studio, where this format today, we're going to be chatting with one of our two black bears who've made it through the 3M challenge. Then we're going to be chatting to Graham, and we're very, very happy to have you here. Tell us a little bit of your backstory, Graham. And what did you do before you discovered Hodlnots and sculpting and before you did the course?
Hodlnots, for me, started at a bad time in my life. You know, life has taught me the lesson of the two twins. And wherever you find opportunity, you're going to find adversity. And obviously the opposite of where there's adversity, you will find opportunity. And that's where I got to join up with Hodlnots. Is I contracted COVID, but I got the bad one. I was literally almost not here. I was dabbling a bit with cryptos, probably since about 2019, following Marius and the team in those days. My gains through the crypto journey on that was actually now depleted to pay for medical costs. So coming out of a sick bed, so you can imagine that is not only mentally and physically taxing on a person, especially being of my age, but financially it devastates you. And when I got out of that bed and I started getting my bearings straight again and paying the bills and just seeing the dollar value diminish out of your portfolio, I thought to myself, whoa, this is troublesome. And there was one of the emails came through or something, and it was talking about the next Hodlnots course. And I said, Hodlnots, sculpting, cash flow, that's what we need to do. And that's how I started with Hodlnots. And I remember this. So I literally took the last money to pay for the course. And from there, I took the Hodlnots course 3rd of October. And there we go, my journey started.
Do you believe in serendipity or chance coincidence?
I won't say I believe in chance. I believe that everything happens for a reason. It's not by accident that all of us are on this call today. There's a reason why we are here. Whether it is to learn, whether it is to assist, whether it is to help. So I think it's more, there's a bigger plan, there's a bigger picture that we don't always understand, but it's not by any means by chance. It's there for a reason.
Tell me, after you did the course in October of 2021, were you in the den from the get-go? Did you take a bit of a break?
I was still quite ill when I took the course. I struggled with my health for probably a year, many a day, just not feeling well, but I would attend the class or I would attend a call and I'd fall asleep just because you're under medication, you're not feeling well, whatever have you. So I was in the den, but I wasn't in the den, if you understand what I'm saying. I was trading, having fun when I could, but it took its toll. But yes, the den, I was definitely in for a good 6-7 months after the course, and then 3M came along.
Okay, so you've been in the den for a while. How was that time for you? I mean, because when we did the course, we were fairly fortunate. The market was still pretty decent. And then, you know, came January, February of last year. You stayed in there because you saw it as an opportunity. Did you stay in there because of the community, or was it the necessity to try to really make it successful in terms of what you were now trying to achieve through sculpting? What was your driving force there?
I think various factors. If you think you're going to go this journey on your own, I think you're going to be mistaken. You're really going to find some headwind. You cannot go this journey alone. For that matter of purpose, that's why you get allocated a trainer on your 3M journey. You need to work with that trainer. You need to check in. You need to be held accountable. So for me, being part of the den, I was holding myself accountable because I had to make this work, because what do I go back to? The world is a different place now after COVID. And, you know, a person in our senior ages, we're not just going to walk into a job again. Yeah, the den was not only a trading space, but it was a supported space. It was a space where you start learning just through observation. You start trying to put into practice what you had been taught on Hodlnots. You know, and in hindsight, it was a jewel those times. The market was way different to what it is now. And it was a lot easier, you know, and that's where we sort of almost underestimated Triple M. We thought, no man, we've got this. Chop chop, we can do this, no problem. And the market kind of brought us down to earth to say, oh, you're not in control, we're in control.